was saying, Amazing Grace, my chains are gone.
You have a voice. You can be in the choir, good or bad. Danielle, we need your help in the choir. Come on, Danielle. Come on. She said no.
Yeah. Morning, I see you in the sunrise every morning. It's like a picture that you've painted for me. Love letter in the sky. Nobody me like you love me, Jesus. I stand in awe of your amazing ways. I worship you as long as I am breathing. God, you are faithful and true. Nobody loves me like you. God, you are faithful and true. Nobody loves me like you.
Praise the Lord. All the singers have grown up singing in this church. Now maybe you've got kids of your own, or maybe that Macy may be fixing to get married off and see what the Lord has in store for your own family. I say to you, you ought to be encouraged. These younger people are filling, I don't want to say filling your shoes, but they're stepping up, and that's an encouragement. Yeah. Amen. It ought to be encouragement. Do you want that to be an encouragement to you, Macy and Lydia and all the rest here that's sang in this church and that has sung all your life, brought up singing? Mm-hmm. Brother Dean McNeese says, said that this has always been God's little music box. What a blessing. Amen. And I'm grateful and thankful that the Lord's allowed me to be a part of his little music box. Amen. All right. So we've changed directions just a little bit this morning. Turn with us to the book of John. I'm going to read to you one verse. John 14, we'll read one verse. Verse number 1. Those that want to stand, be welcome to do so. Reverence of reading God's word. John 14 and verse number 1, it said, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me." Let us pray. Lord, you know, Father, that we need you this morning. We're thankful for each and everything that's been said, been done, Lord. Know that there's several folks that's traveling this morning, Father, and we know that they several that's sick, Father, and afflicted. God, we pray that you would be with each and every one of those. Father, as we come to you this morning, Lord, we say thank you for another privilege of being behind this sacred desk and wish that I'm so unworthy. God, I pray that you would encourage hearts that's here. Father, I pray for those that maybe tuning in by way of internet, Father, I pray a special blessing upon them. And God, I pray that, Lord God, that you would just use us, Lord God, for your music box this morning. And Lord, that you would just use us, Lord God, for a soul winning station for you. And God, that you would be honored and glorified in everything said and done. Lord, I'm absolutely nothing without you. God, I pray that you would forgive me where I fail you. Lord, guard my tongue. Lord God, hide me behind your cross for a little while. And Lord, I pray, God, that you would pass from breast to breast, Lord God. And Father, encourage that heart that's here in your precious name. Amen. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated. So Jesus is speaking here, and familiar scripture to us, and can quote a lot of that chapter, and
It's just times that within our life that he draws you back somewhere.
Yeah. Yeah.
That he draws you back in remembrance, or if he draws you back into his word, of all the times that he's been an encouragement, of all the times that he's been there for you. And as he brings you back to those scriptures, you begin to think about all those times. I don't know about you, but that's where I'm at this morning. In times of trouble, in times of heartache, in times of sadness, in times of grief, in times of not understanding, in times in which that of sickness, in times of that we just don't have any answers. Amen. He directs my heart to this John 14, verse number 1. You may say, Brother Tim, I'm not really there this morning. Feel pretty good. Feel pretty good about things that's taken place. And maybe you're on that mountaintop this morning. Well, I would say praise the Lord for that. But let this verse be an encouragement to you then too. See, a lot of folks, a lot of Christian folks, we want to use the Lord as a spare tire. We don't think about it until we get in a situation that we need that spare tire. Daniel checks the air pressure in his spare tire. I don't even know if my vehicle's got one in it or not. Amen. But that's the way a lot of Christian folks, can I say that we as Christian folks need to be more like Daniel? We need to make sure that the things between us and the Lord are exactly where and how they need to be. Amen? That way you can have confidence. Confidence that if something happens, confidence that if something takes place, and there's all of those things in which I just made mention, that in a moment that everything can be just great and everything can be just going as according to our plans, and then all of a sudden we're blindsided with something. At that time, if we're in the will of God and if we're right where we need to be with Him, He is all those things in which that I made mention of in the past few weeks. He's help, He's strength, He's protection. He'll stick closer than a brother. Amen? But unfortunately, we find ourselves, if we do, treat Him a lot of times like that spare tire. Through the week, we don't think about Him much. Through the week, we just kind of go through the motions. It's easy to do. Listen, it's very innocent, no doubt. But through the week, we go through the motion, and we. That's why Wednesday night is so very important for the preacher. Amen. I need Wednesday nights. I need Sunday nights. Amen. That's the time that we can recharge. Amen. That's what the sanctuary is about, that we come in and we get filled up spiritually. That we can get encouraged spiritually. And you say, preacher, you preach mean to us. Amen, listen here. There's a difference in somebody just preaching mean to you. You listen, there's still a feeling even through some of that rough preaching. Amen? I don't know about you, but I've got to have that rough preaching. I've got to have that in order for things to lay out and in order for things to make sense to me. Amen? I've got to have that. And I've got to have them whippings, amen? I've got to have those things that draw back. But I think about this. I think about that verse number 1 and what he's speaking. He's speaking to Thomas there, and not just Thomas, but his disciples. They're not understanding what's fixing to take place. He's going down through there, and as he goes through those scriptures right there, those first 6 scriptures, he's speaking to Thomas and speaking not now, not just Thomas, but he's speaking to all of us. But I like how that he starts that verse number 1 out. Let me just read on down in verse number 2, and I'll read down through about verse number 6, but it said, in my Father's house are many mansions. Started that out, but let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go prepare a place for you. I like that. And if I go prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whether I go, you know, and the way, you know. And Thomas said unto him, Thomas was confused. Like many of us through the week, and like many of us so oftentimes, there's some confusion that takes place. Amen. Now, we know that the Lord's not the author of confusion. But you know what? There's times that Tim Hamby is confused. Even today, I've been in the ministry a good while. Even yet today, there's times that there's confusion that takes place, and I can't wrap my mind around. But you know what? That just because I can't wrap my mind around it ain't got nothing to do with me wrapping my heart around what I know is true. You see, that's a good thing about being a child of God, and that's a good thing about being saved today. I don't got to wrap my mind around things. Amen. All I got to do is allow God to speak to my heart. Amen. And if we allow him to speak to our hearts, it don't matter the confusion that's taking place in the world. It don't matter the confusion that may be taking place within our own families. You know what? We hold true to what we know is true. Goes on and he says right there. So Thomas was confused. He wasn't understanding what Jesus was saying. And he saith unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou goest. And he goes on, how can we know the way? And of course, Jesus speaks to him right there, and he says to him very plainly, I am the way. He's the way this morning. He's the way this morning. He's the only way. Thank you, Brother Donnie. He's the only way this morning. He said, I am the way, the truth, the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. If you pay attention to what he said up there, on up there, in the second part of that first verse, he said, if you believe in God, believe also in me. Verse number 6, he said, no man can cometh unto the Father but by me. Talking about Jesus. Talking about the shed blood of Jesus Christ. Now let me try to pick up the speed right here. Let me try to wrap this thing up. I know, and listen, don't start looking at your watches. Amen. Listen, here's the message this morning. At whatever it is that you're dealing with, at whatever it is that you're facing, this is how the Lord's laid upon my heart and directed our heart this morning. Here's what he spoke to me just this week. And if he's willing to speak to me just this week, amen, he's willing to speak to you. And he's willing to speak to you this morning. Verse number 1, let not your heart be troubled. I wonder how many times Thomas thought about that as they were whipping Jesus at that whipping post. Wonder how many times Thomas was thinking about that and the doubt that may have set in when he seen that they had crucified Jesus. Wonder how many thoughts had been through his mind with all the things in which that was fixing to happen. Jesus yet told him, "Let not your heart be troubled." The message this morning, church, is this. Let not your heart be troubled. Whatever it is you're dealing, whatever it is you're facing, whatever it is you're fixing to face, whatever it is that you're going through, let not your heart be troubled. Whatever it is that and wish that you're fixing that is fixing to get dumped on you, and I hope that that is not the case by all means. But you know what? Let not your heart be troubled. Listen, if all of our jobs tomorrow closes down and everything shuts down and everything just comes to a screeching halt, let me just say this: let not your heart be troubled. You're His this morning, amen, according to the Scripture. And there is nothing that the devil can do. What can separate, Romans chapter number, what can separate you and the love of God? Nor height, nor depth, nor any creature, amen, nor the devil, nor demon, the demons of hell. Listen, there's absolutely that nothing can separate you and the love of God. And thanks be to God this morning that God the Creator and God the Son are as one. And we're not left alone, because He told them right there later part in that chapter, He said, I pray that the Father, that He'll not leave you comfortless. And He said there that He's going to send something by our way. Here's something for you this morning. Amen. You may be discouraged. You may be down. Or listen, you may be fixing to face something this week. I got a good news for you, friend. You're not going to face it alone. He told His disciples there. He said, I'll pray that the Father, that He'll not leave you comfortless, but He said, I'll pray that He'll send a comforter your way. I'm glad this morning that Tim Hamby has got a comforter that lives within inside of him. And when things take place, and when things don't make sense, He speaks that small, still voice to our hearts and says, let not your heart be troubled. Woo! Amen. Peace be still. They didn't know what He was talking about when He was talking about the comforter coming on scene either. They were confused about that till Acts chapter number 2. The very one that denied Him, the very one that failed Him, the very one that done all that stuff, He was standing and preaching to a multitude, every tongue, at different languages there. You know what? They all understood when that third part of the Trinity came on scene. That third part of the Trinity, the Holy Ghost, come through in a mighty rushing wind. Amen. 3,000 were born again. I say that's powerful, don't you? You know what? That same power lives within you. That same comforter that He's speaking to them about, it's for you to be had. It's for yours to be had today. So let not your heart be troubled. Let not your heart be troubled. Been so many times. Been hurting this thing. Been discouraged. Thanks be to God that there's something that lives inside of us. When you can't get a hold of your best friend, or your wife's mad at you and you can't even talk to her. That don't ever happen our way, but just thought I'd throw that out there. But there's something inside of us. It says, oh son, oh daughter, let not your heart be troubled. Oh, the comfort. Comfort to be had through that. The comfort knowing Him this morning as your Savior. Let not your heart be troubled. I don't understand so many things. Stood at caskets so many times and with question in my mind, I don't understand. Just don't understand. Believing in the finished work of Calvary, taking my place as a sinner, accepting the Lord Jesus Christ as my Savior, I don't have to understand. But I'm thankful and grateful that there's comfort to be had. What I want you to know this morning is, let not your heart be troubled. some of these days when all this things, I told you I've been a little homesick this week. Anybody ever get homesick? And I'm not talking about your physical home, but I'm talking about you, so your home that lays a weight for us. It's been worked on right now. You said, I'll go to prepare a place for you. He's preparing that place for me. Amen. He's not just me. Amen. And some people say that if I just got a little shack on the outskirts. No, sir. I've got a mansion in glory. Amen. And guess what? It don't matter how rotten you've been or how rotten you are. If you've accepted the Lord as your Savior, honey, you've got a mansion too, just like I do. Yeah. I'm not going to have no shack on the outskirts of glory. He's going to prepare a place for me. He's going to prepare a place for you. And it's going to be yours. Amen. Amen. So let not your heart be troubled. So I get homesick. There's something wrong with us, with inside of us, if we don't get homesick from time to time. Amen. I'm glad of those times that I'm homesick, aren't you? I'm glad to know that I'm just passing through here. Our lives are but a vapor, and what the book of James said in the 4th chapter, that appeared for a little time, and then guess what? It's gone, amen. It's gone. You're going to blink, and 20 years have gone by. You kids, don't be sitting back there grinning. Don't be sitting back there acting like you're bored out of your mind. I got good news for you, honey. 20 years is going to pass by like that. 40 years is going to pass by like that. And I'm standing here before you remembering the words of the saints of God that stood at one point in time and told me the same thing. Honey, your life is but a vapor that appeareth for a little time. You don't get a makeover. You don't get a redo. You don't get a rewind, honey. It's what you make of it. And hey, man, I've got good news for you. You say my life's in shambles. Well, the Bible said right here to let not your heart be troubled. You say I've got trouble at every end. The Bible says right here, let not your heart be troubled. That ain't the preacher's word. That ain't the deacon's word. That ain't Calvary's words. But that's God's word to you. Let not your heart be trouble. You say I've got trouble at every end. Don't understand. I've got family and friend that don't care nothing about serving God. Don't care. Listen, the Bible said, let not your heart be troubled. Amen. I've got family and I've got friends. I've got family that's never accepted the Lord. But the Bible said here to not let your heart be troubled. I pray for them. I beg them to come to the house of God. I beg them to be born again. Well, but the Bible, listen, we can't get burdened down with that so much that it affects our worship. Let not your heart be troubled. Amen. There's comfort to be had in that. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. Created all creation in 6 days and rested on the seventh. Amen. Y'all believe that, don't you? Amen. I believe that. I know you did. I was just waking you up there a little bit. Rested on the seventh. He's been working on my mansion since I accepted him. He's been working on your mansion since you accepted him. And it's yours. So let not your heart be troubled this morning. Let not your heart be troubled. Let not your heart be troubled that you don't understand. Don't let your heart be troubled. You listen to that small, still voice in your heart, and there'll be comfort to be had. Listen, our economy may crash tomorrow. Your dollar may not be worth nothing tomorrow. Let not your heart be troubled. I'm going to tell you what he's going to do. Let me just tell you what he's going to do. Something bad come by your way. Yeah, I didn't come up with this. I watched another preacher do it, and it worked pretty good. So Let me tell you what he's going to do, Brother Donnie. Something bad comes by that way, he's going to give you a little extra grace.
Yes.
Guess what? There's more to be had.
Yeah.
Ain't that good? I've waited many, many years to use this right. I had no idea I was going to use this way. Had no idea. You got some rotten kids, Tony. There's some extra grace to be had this week. We're not going to pay no attention to that part. You've got a fantastic husband, Tyler. Just some extra grace, son. Hey, still grace, still something in there. Ain't that wonderful? Hey, man. Oh, Kelly, you got a rotten one home too, don't you, buddy? I love her with all my heart. I'll give you 4 or 5. Here, let me give you some extra. That's that extra grace you're going to need this week. Not because of Anna. Don't you tell her I said that. Oh, Dave, it's going to be a long week for you. It's been a long week last few weeks. Work's heavy. You're in a rough business. It's rewarding. You'll make sure you've got enough grace this week to make it through. Honey, I don't even know your name. I don't think David does neither. He said he didn't know who you was. There's grace to be had. Amber, you got to put up all of them. I'm going to give you half the box. A little extra. Let not your heart be troubled. Boys, let not your heart be troubled. Where are you going to be working at next week? You don't know. But you know there's grace to be had. Ain't that something? You graduated yet? Yeah. You're going to need to leave me a little extra. Aiden, where are you? Aiden's going to be a senior this year. Aren't you glad there's grace for that? Ain't that something? See, that's how God. That's his blessings to you. That's his love toward you. When you think it's end, it just keeps on coming. So you can let not your heart be troubled this morning. Yeah. Daniel, you and Mike, you're in bad shape. Here you go. I'm going to pour it on both of you. Lisa, I'll give you one. But there's still grace to be had. I was working my way back here, Miss Carol.
Thank you.
Heard you some. Been alone a few weeks. Heard you some extra.
Thank you. Thank the Lord.
Oh, honey, that ain't nothing but snot rags right there. But it's signifying God's grace. It's signifying, let not your heart be troubled this morning, Missy. Because there's extra grace to be had. That peace, that third part of the Trinity that he sent. Oh, Vernon, you can clean your head with that right there. Yeah, you've already got some, ain't you? If you need some, all you got to do is call on him. Yeah. But until then, he's going to give you a little bit anyway. Amen. Yes. It's to be had. Be had this week. Oh, Brother Lonnie. He said, just let your heart not be troubled.
Yeah.
You believe in him, don't you?
Amen.
You've accepted him, ain't you?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Listen here, church. There's still plenty of grace. There's still plenty of mercy. Right here's, I handed some out right there. That's what it signifies, but there's still plenty to be had right here. That's just this old snot rag. Hey, man, but listen, there's plenty of grace and there's still plenty of mercy right here to be had. So I say, hey, God's word to you this morning, let not your heart be troubled. There's mercy and there's grace, and we're going to make it. Amen. Let us stand to our feet. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you again for your grace and all you do for us, Lord. We thank you, Lord God, that you would see fit, Lord God, to pass by our way. Lord, I know as the singers come, Lord God, to get a song, Father, I pray and ask God that you'd extend that grace. Lord, there may not be somebody here. There may be somebody here that don't know you in the free pardon of sin, God. Lord God, I pray, Lord God, that they come and accept that grace and accept that mercy. Lord God, accept that comfort, Lord God, to be had. God, I pray, Lord God, that you'd beckon their heart, Lord God. Oh, Lord, help us, God, as we, everyone, are homesick. Lord God, help us, Lord God, that we, everyone, Lord God, need that extra grace. Need your extra mercy, Lord. Oh, but Father, there's comfort to be had in knowing that we don't got to let our heart be troubled this morning. We believe in you. We've accepted you. And we're yours. And God, I just pray and ask this morning that you'd pass by, Lord God, if there be a need, Lord God, here, Father. If there be somebody, Lord God, here, Father, that needs that extra grace, Lord God. Father, that needs that extra. Father, God, that may need that extra word with you, Father, I pray and ask, God, that you'd, that they'd just come, Lord God, and call upon you. And Lord, I pray that you'd just have your way in our hearts, Lord. Thank you so much, God, for the week. Lord God, and understanding and knowing, Lord God, that even though the weeks get long and they get hard, God, Lord God, this ain't even our home. Lord, we're just passing through. And God, I thank you for that. Thank you so much. Realizing and understanding that this thing is just a vapor. And Lord, I pray that you just have your way. For it's in your precious name, I do pray. Amen. Amen.